My name is Karina Pombo-Garcia, and I'm doing my PhD in the Helmholtz Center in Dresden-Rosendorf. And yeah, I think I'm a little bit of a dreamer.
And your dream is to better detect cancer.
Detect cancer at an early stage, it's one of the best cures that we have at the moment. That means that if we detect it very soon, we have much more chances to cure cancer than if we detect it later on. That is where detection of cancer is so important, and that is very challenging.
Why is it that difficult to detect cancer nowadays?
So, at the moment, we normally we don't have the technology to detect it on a very early stage, and we need more sophisticated techniques that increase in sensitivity when the medical doctors that the medical doctors can use in the clinic. So that is the big challenge.
Which was the goal of your PhD?
So my research is based on small nanoparticles that once they are injected into the patient allows the doctors to visualize much more precisely and sensitive the cancer. So the goal of my PhD has been develop a new novel system, ultra small particles. So we're talking about particles smaller than 5 nanometers that on the surface of these little balloons, we decorated with different things. So the challenge was to put those different things onto the surface and make the whole complex still something worth trying. So on the surface, we had like a small light that allow us to follow the tumor. We also had like another substance, like another molecule that carries what we need to detect the cancer via PET imaging. And it also has like a small key. If we imagine that it's like a key that will open the door, so that door will be the cancer cells. And that key address the nanoparticles, where do they have to go? And at the same time, avoid that these nanoparticles go somewhere else, like to think to organs that we don't want them to go. So it has been a big challenge because it has been a lot of mix of biology, chemistry, biochemistry, physiology in one single thing.
Why is that difficult to find a substance?
Well, it is difficult to find the substance, but it's more difficult to bring that substance into the human body. Because in our body, we have like a police that is called immune system. And what this immune system does is that will degrade any kind of substance that he doesn't like it, let's say it this way. So if that happens, whatever we have created, it makes no sense because it will never reach the cancer. So that is the challenge, to inject, to create something that it's still compatible with the human body.
What was the biggest challenge during your PhD?
The biggest challenge was to stick to what you think that is the right thing to do. I mean, you will deal with many people that will just say that, you know, this is not possible, or like, how are you going to prove this, or like, this is too much work, or you have not. So I think the biggest challenge was to say, I believe in this and I will carry out with what I have done.
What did you discover?
Well, what I've reached after these 4 years of PhD, it's we have developed a new system that we have tried in vitro and in vivo with promising results. And from the basic knowledge point of view, it was a huge step, I think.
Is there a day that stood out in a special way?
Yes, I think that the day that we tried the 2 days, I would say. So one day, it was the day that I tried we saw the first video of how these particles internalize into cells. So we kind of see which direction are they taking, where, and opening many more questions. Why are they going here, not to somewhere else where we would have expected? And also the day that we tried in vivo. Although there are many things to improve in the results, I think it was so exciting to see how this system work in living organism. And it was a funny story because I sent one of the videos to my mom, although she's not from the field, but you know, I was so excited, like, oh, look at that. Okay, I think I showed it to many people, but yeah. I think if you are passionate about your work, you always want to spread it around.
Who inspires you?
My big inspiration, it comes always from my parents, because they always push me to do, to give me the freedom to do whatever I want to do without asking me, why are you doing this now? Or like, think of the next step, or think of what are you going to do? I never had that pressure. I always had 100% support from their side. And that is very inspiring, because it's just like, they are pushing you to develop yourself.
What make nanoparticles so special to you?
Nanoparticles is like playing with these little Legos that the kids play with. So you change something and nanoparticle becomes something different completely to what it was before. And you can keep on changing and keep on investigating what else can you do with them. And at the same time, it's very challenging because there's no methodology to characterize them so precisely yet. And that it makes it a very exciting topic to research on.
And how important is communication for research?
Communication is very important for the society, because society wants to know what researchers are doing in their labs. And it's a way to pay off that they support us with their taxes. Most of us get paid by government institutions. So it's a good feedback. But at the same time, and it's a point that not many people see, is that researchers are expertise in whatever they do. So it means that they are the ones who have to teach people about big challenges of the society nowadays. So I see researchers as educators somehow.
Is there anything that you would like to change?
I would like to believe that the only limitation that scientists have to have is to the creativity that they have, and not something else. So I know that we have to still deal with other things, but I think the main limitation should be creativity and not other random things.
What is your wish for the future?
I think we need dreamers in life, not just in research, but in any field. We need people that do things passionately and that dream very big. Especially in research, we need dreamers, because in most cases, we work with things that we don't know, or we don't know how are they going to experience or how they're going to react. So we need in research to leave our creativity and freedom very, very, very free. So we need to dream.
Thank you very much, Karina.
Yeah, you're welcome, Medina. Thank you very much for this interview.